Hi, welcome to the question right here. So we got a little graph right here trying to show you some kind of relationship. So what we have here is the cost of the chocolate bars, okay? So we got the y-axis here and the x-axis here. So remember, the x-axis is your independent variables. Here we have the number of the chocolate bars, okay? So we got 1 all the way up to 10. Over here on the y-axis, you got the cost of the chocolate bars. So if you see here, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 dots. These dots are telling you the number of chocolates and their price according to the number of chocolates you're buying. So let's say, for example, if you have one chocolate bar right here, let me just fill in the table right here for you. If you have one chocolate bar, it's going to cost you $2, okay? Now if you buy two, it's going to cost you $4, okay? And if you buy three, it's going to cost you $6, okay? So what's a little, and so on until you get the 6 chocolate bar, it's going to cost you $12. So what's the relationship or the pattern that's represented by this graph right here? Well, the pattern is that for every chocolate bar that you buy, it's a $2 increase, okay? And you probably got that already just by looking at the first one. Every chocolate bar is $2, okay? So every time you increase your chocolate bar by 1, of course over here, you'll increase by 2, okay? So that's the pattern. Basically, every chocolate bar is going to cost you $2, okay? Thanks for watching.